Hello everyone, in this video we'll see how to do early parsing. So early parsing is a type of top down parser. Here it works for all type of context free grammar, not like our CYK algorithm where it is specific for a context free grammar in Chomsky normal form, whereas in case of a early parser it works for all type of context free grammar. Even a grammar has a left recursion or left factoring or even ambiguous grammar can be parsed using this early parser. But the problem here is like it is a bit slow process, so we are not going to implement all this early parser in terms of compiler design and all. But for other applications we can use this early parser. So here we are going to have three main operations. As of this early parser is considered, like we have three main operations of early parser, that is predict, scan and complete. Predict is used to predict what will be the next step. So what all the non-terminal that we want to expand in next step, so that will come in predict operation. And scan is to check what all things that is passed already to with the input. Like we have to check whether the input belongs to the grammar or not, right? And then it generate a parse tree. So we have to compare the input with the generated grammatical structure. So that comparison is done using scan operation. And complete is to complete what all the things already done. If an input is processed till some nth element, we have to check what all the non-terminal that derives it. So that is your use of complete operation. And here we use a dot, like in case of your LR parser, we use a dot structure, right? Similarly, we are going to use a dot to represent the moment of operation. Like initially we have a dot over here. And when this hello is scanned, we'll check for all the non-terminal that actually fit into the structure and all. And we move a dot ahead. So each time we take an individual word and we compare it with the existing element. We take a terminal symbol and we compare it with the existing grammar. We process it. And then after processing, this processing is called scan operation. And after processing, we move a dot over here. So here, this is a completed place. So here all the non-terminal that is used to generate hello will be updated over here. So that is done in complete operation. And predict will be the next element to be processed. So what might be there to predict next? So that is there. So here for completing this early parser, we have to start it out over here. And we have to scan each and every terminal symbol. And finally we have to end up over here. So when all the elements in the parse tree are completely scan, it's thoroughly scanned, then it actually generates a parse tree structure out of it. So that is early parser. Now we'll take an example and I'll say you how to do this process. Consider an example like this. So here this is a grammatic structure actually. How does a sentence can be, all the noun, verb and all. So that is the structure given over here, and we are going to consider an input like this: Papu drinks milk with chocolate, something like this. So we are going to check whether this sentence is grammatically correct according to the context free grammar or not. So here again, as I told you, we are going to use a dot symbol. Starts from here. Each time I scan an input, compare it with the existing thing and I'll do all predict complete operation. So I have to scan each and every element as it is. So here the terminal symbols are like this: Papu drink milk with chocolate. So all these elements as a whole we call it as a terminal symbol. So we are going to check one terminal at a time and we have to end till here. So here we are going to use a matrix like structure, and the length of matrix is like when I take an input of length n, like here it is 1 2 3 4 5. 5 is the length, and we are going to move the dot from this place, right? So here I have to start with 0th place, 1 2 3 4, 5th place I have to complete it. So I am going to create a matrix structure from 0 to 5 to trace all the input as it is, like this. So this actually denotes the moment of scan of input, and this is your level of prediction. So topmost it is the level of prediction, you are not bothered about it, and this is very important, like we are going to move scan an input accordingly. So here I'll just start the process of thing. Initially, while starting, we are going to introduce a new variable. We call that variable as seed. Like we introduce an augmented grammar. Like we start with the variable top. I start with top as the variable. This is your seed. Top tends to the starting element of the grammar. So that is S. And we are going to use this dot in front of it. Since this is a starting place, I haven't scanned any of the input at. So I start a dot with here. And one thing you want to note, whenever you have a non-terminal after a dot, we have to expand it. So that process is called prediction. So after dot, what is there? You're going to expand it. So that is called a prediction operation. So here S is a non-terminal. So for S, we have a prediction. So we have to substitute it. S tends to dot NP VP. So again, after this dot, it is a non-terminal. Expand it. For NP, we have two possible predictions. One is NP tends to dot NP PP and NP tends to dot N. And again, we have an after this dot, it is a NP. NP is a non-terminal. We have already expanded NP. No need to write it again. And next one is N. So again, N is a non-terminal. We have to expand N. What happened here? For N, we have all the predictions that has just a terminal symbol LO. So when it is in this case, whenever a terminal symbol comes, then we have to check with the input whether it is correct or not, right? So here we are going to compare all N's input with the statement. So here, as per my input, the first element is Papu. I have to check whether N's prediction, any of this N's prediction has Papu inside. If none of the things have it, so it is an error case. We have to report that input doesn't belong to the grammar. In case if you have it, then we have to scan the input. So now we have a prediction N tends to Papu. So that is of a proper structure. So we have to scan it. So here what happened, like after scanning this N tends to Papu, we have scanned it, right? So we have to move a dot over here, a step ahead. So we can write it like here, due to N tends to Papu is there, we can move it a step ahead. So here we are going to scan the input. So I can move this star, this dot after this. So I can write this prediction as N tends to Papu dot. So this operation, we call it as scan operation. Scan is comparing the existing prediction with the input. If some match occurs, we are going to scan the input. So in this place, while making a scan, we have to move a step ahead. Okay. Now after scanning the input, we have to complete the process. So here N tends to Papu is done. So we have to check a prediction that already we have N inside. So here we have a prediction NP tends to N. So here I can move a dot over here. So since based on this, we got this Papu's prediction, right? So I can rewrite this prediction as NP tends to N dot. This means that we have already processed this N. This N is scanned. Yeah, this N tends to Papu, that is scanned, right? Again, now this NP is also scanned. We have two different predictions that has NP in the starting element. Like after this dot, we have NP. So we have to rewrite it as S tends to NP dot VP and NP tends to NP dot PP. So this is your complete operation. I told you now, predict is like when you have a, after this dot, when you have a non-terminal, we have to expand it. So that is predict operation. Scan is whenever a non-terminal tends to a terminal symbol comes, we have to compare that with the input symbol and we have to complete the process. We have to move a step ahead and we have to check for the next input element. So that is your scan operation, and complete is to complete the process. When a terminal symbol comes, we are going to check what will be the next element, what all the things that is already processed. So that is your complete. So here we have completed, like NP is already done. I have moved the dot ahead and we got a prediction like this. So this is your complete operation. And what happened here? Now this is done, one step ahead. Like I got a dot over here. Papu is done. So that is the reason I have it in 0, 1. So first position, like we have moved from 0 to first position now. Now next step is we have a non-terminal, like we have to proceed with this grammar structure. Here we have a variable, like after this dot we have a variable. So we have to use predict operation. So when you have a non-terminal, like we usually call it as non-terminal, when a non-terminal comes after a dot, we have to expand it. So we have to write the expansion over here. So this is your next step. So I take next column of it. So here, next row of it, I am going to expand. After this dot, we have VP. So for VP's prediction, we have two prediction for VP, that is VP tends to dot VNP. Since just now we are going to scan this input, we haven't processed that, we have to use this dot over here in the first position of it. And again, next we have VP tends to dot VPNP, sorry, PP. VP tends to VP, PP. So two predictions for VP, and again what happened here, we have one prediction for PP, sorry, PP, we have one prediction, that is PP tends to dot PNP. The reason why we are writing all these things is after this dot we have VP, so we have to expand VP to prediction. And here as per this prediction, after this dot we have PP, for PP we have only one prediction, we have to expand it. Now this is done. So again what happened here, after this dot we have V, VP and P, all are non-terminals. So here what happened, after this dot it is the V, we have to expand it, after this dot it is VP, already done, and after this dot we have P. So we have to expand V and P. We have to expand what is there in V's prediction and P's prediction. What happened here, P prediction it tends to a variable, a terminal symbol, that is with, and V's prediction it tends to drinks, okay, some terminal symbols. Now when you have a terminal symbol, we have to compare it with the input. Now what happened here, in input we, the next element to be processed is drink, and we have a prediction V tends to drink, so we have to eliminate this P. P is not matching with this, so we have to eliminate this P, and we just take this prediction V tends to drink alone over here. So we take V tends to drink. So with this, a match occurs over here, so we have to scan the input. So V tends to drink is done. So second step is also done, we can write V tends to drink dot. So this is done. So when V's prediction is done, what happened, we can move this prediction over here. For VP tends to V, we can make it as, this is your complete process, V tends to V dot NP. Since V is done, we are going to update it as VP tends to V dot NP, and we have to proceed this, we have to repeat the procedure again and again. So after this dot we have, like, the remaining predictions won't work, okay, so we can again proceed it with this prediction is totally done. The reason is, like, we have P and P doesn't have a match, so we can complete it, but this we can't directly remove it. The reason is we have VP, and VP we have proceeded to the step, so we have to check whether it is clearing it in the next step only, so we can have this as it is. Now we can start proceeding for the remaining element. So now after this dot we have NP. So when NP is a non-terminal, we have to use predict again. So we have to expand predict. For predict, NP will be expanded. For NP we have two different prediction, NP tends to NP PP and NP tends to N, okay, all with dot at the starting of it. So now we have NP, after this dot we have NP, NP is already expanded, and after this dot we have N. For N we have to expand N, okay. So what happened here, N has four different prediction and all with all set of terminal symbol. So again we have to compare it, like, we have processed till this drink and we have to expand it, right? So next one we need to, the next input is milk. We have to check whether there is a prediction N tends to milk or not. There is a prediction that has N tends to milk. We just take this alone and we proceed it. So here we have a scan over here. So this milk and this milk matches together. So we can rewrite this prediction as N tends to milk dot over here. So since that milk process is processed, I'll have dot over here and dot over here. So this is done. What is next step? We have to complete the process. While making it complete, N tends to milk is complete, and we have a prediction NP tends to N. So since N is complete, we have to make NP tends to N dot. And again, what happened to this prediction? This we can rewrite it as NP tends to NP dot PP. So since this NP is complete, we can rewrite it as NP tends to NP dot PP. So again, here we have completed this NP as a whole. So we can rewrite the prediction as it is. Directly we can rewrite it as VP tends to VNP. And again, this prediction also, we should not leave any prediction. Okay, so we can take this prediction, we can rewrite it as VP tends to, this VP is totally complete, right? So we can write it as VP dot PP. Another step of process, again we can proceed with this. So here also we can rewrite it. See, here we have a prediction S tends to NP and again dot VP. VP is already done. We have scanned with VP. So we can rewrite it as S tends to NP VP dot. And again we can proceed with this. So here after this step, what happened? Like after complete, we have a non-terminal after this. So when you have a non-terminal, we have to expand it. So that is your predict process. So we can we have to expand PP. What happened with the prediction for PP? It is P and NP. So dot P and NP. So here again we have a variable P. We have to expand P. For P we have only one prediction, that is P tends to width. So we have to compare it with the input symbol. We have already processed till milk. So we have to check whether the next element matches with this or not. Yeah, it matches, right? We have P tends to dot milk, sorry, width. And that matches with the input. So we can directly scan the input. We can rewrite it as P tends to width dot. So this is your scan operation and we have to complete it. Like this P is completed. So we can rewrite this prediction for PP as P dot NP. So after this dot we have NP and on terminal expand this. We have NP tends to, for NP we have two predictions. One is NP tends to NP dot NP PP. And NP tends to dot N. And again we have to expand this N. For N we have all all terminal symbols. So when you have terminal symbol, we have to compare it with the input. When there is a match, we have to scan it. So here we have chocolate and N tends to chocolate is already there. We can use that prediction. Chocolate. So we can use that prediction. Here it is dot chocolate. We have to scan the input. So while scanning the input, I can rewrite it as N tends to chocolate dot. And because of this, this N is completed. So NP tends to N dot. And here, complete process, NP tends to NP dot PP. Okay, so after this step, the input is processed. It is totally done. So we have to complete this step as a whole. So all the five elements in the input is properly scanned and we got a solution, right? We got it till chocolate. Now to take the important things alone, we have to proceed like this. So we move from here. So this N is totally done. NP. Okay, N tends to NP is done. So here this P we can take. Okay, and this is incomplete. We can't take this prediction. So we just check the completed portions alone. So here we have expanded N and this N tends to NP. And here we have NP completed, right? This NP is processed over here. We can rewrite it as PP tends to P NP dot. So we have taken this and P dot width. And again here this PP comes from here, right? So this is the PP then that we have expanded here. We can rewrite it as NP tends to NP PP dot. Whereas this NP is expanded over here. So this as a whole we have expanded from this place. See, we have already updated here. So we can just rewrite it. VP tends to VNP. And even this PP is already done. PP we have expanded. No need to write it. We can write one prediction alone. And here it is S tends to NP VP. If you want, we can rewrite all the elements together. I'll just circle it off what all the elements that are needed. N tends to Papu and this N and we have this. Okay, because of this, we have this drink. And here we have this VP, N tends to milk and N tends to NP and we have this here. Okay, here. And these are all the final predictions that we can take for it. So here, note this. with the dot at the end, we have to consider and these two predictions. So these are all the final predictions that we can use it for deriving a parse tree. Now to generate a parse tree, I can do it. Okay, now when we consolidate it, we will have a graph structure like this, where we start from S. S tends to NPVP, and this N is expanded here, and this V over here, and we have this NP tends to NPVP, and this N is expanded over here, PP is expanded over here, PP tends to P and NP, and this P is width, and NP is expanded over here. So we have a parse tree structure like this. So this is early parser. We get a confusion over here. See, we have something that is relevant to the input. The reason is the grammar that we have taken is an ambiguous grammar. We have two different parse tree structure over here. So this early parser will work even in case of a ambiguous grammar. Okay, so this is much efficient grammar. The problem here is it takes a lot of time to process. I have taken an input with a five structure and length of five, and I have taken so much of time for doing all the process, whereas when you have an input of n number of length, it takes time. So that is a only drawback with early parser. So early parser, even it works with left recursion, left factor grammar, and it works for all type of context-free grammar. Okay, thank you.